Jim DeWan. I write the prep school column for the Good Eating section of the Chicago Tribune. And I'm here with John Kass, a columnist for the Chicago Tribune. Look at him, there he is. And we're going to poach eggs because John said, poach me some eggs. And I said, yes, sir, Mr. Kass. So look, we're going to do this.
I've never poached an egg, ever.
Oh, my God.
So it'll be good to learn.
If you can crack an egg, you can poach an egg.
All right.
That's not true. You got to be able to turn on the stove, too. All right. But look, I've got two bowls of water here. We're going to call that poaching liquid. And I've got it. Poaching temperature is between 160 and 180 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay? You want
just no... Just before the bubbles start.
You want no motion because mm-hmm. the egg just wants to sit there.
Got
all right?
It.
All right. So look. Want to crack an egg in there?
Sure. Into this.
Yeah. You know why? Because it's easier. This is like hot water, and sometimes if you put your hand down too close, you shove your hand into the hot water, and then you end up screaming and cursing, and it's a big mess. Let's do one more. I'm going to put a little bit of vinegar.
Why do you put the vinegar in?
Because, I'm glad you asked me. Because acid acts on proteins just like heat does. And so by adding the acid in the form of vinegar to the water, it's going to hold the egg a little bit closer. All right, so yeah, just lower the egg in there. Just dump it in there carefully. Get as close to the water as you can. There you go. Yeah, just get it like right down next to the water. There you go. Just like that. Beautiful.
Better on the second try, right? You don't want it to hit the bottom and
right.
smash open.
Okay, so now through the magic of television, 3.5 minutes have passed. And we're ready to try our eggs, all right? So now, once again, so let's take a look at this one. I'm gonna move the accent out of the way. I'm just gonna jiggle a little bit, and you can see it's still a little bit soft right there. So I'm just gonna put it back in for probably about another 30 seconds. All right, just like that. All right, and what my favorite thing in the world is, see how easy that is, by the way?
I've never seen an egg dried.
All right, so watch. I'm just going to dump this, flip it over, right on top of that salad. I love a poached egg on salad. All right.
That looks...
Scrumptious? Is that the word you're looking for?
I hadn't thought of that. Poached egg on salad. No.
Oh, my God. A plate
of
white beans.
Of course.
A little pepper. All right, so look. So now watch. So now, I got this nice dressed salad, and then when you cut into the egg, then that yolk... just spills out over the salad. It makes it sound like a little sauce.
Perfect.
So look, there's a poached egg. How easy was that?
Extremely easy.
Extremely.
Just to make sure the water is not boiling or motion in the water.
No motion in the water.
So bring it up to a boil.
Between 160 and 180 degrees if you got a thermometer. But just look at that. It's just not moving.
So okay? Bring it up to a boil, drop it down so there's no motion.
Let it go for
3.5 minutes.
Vinegar,
a little salt, egg, let it sit.
You got it. Three
Perfect.
And a half minutes, you're done.
Thanks,
John.
Thank you, Chef. So, Chef, if people want to see you do these things live, these demonstrations, where would they go?
Well, if they were struck with such a crazy notion, they would go to Kendall College on November 18th. It's a Monday night. One of the best nights of the week, I might add. And I'm doing a demo there in the evening. Jennifer Weigel's going to be there. So it's going to be a big,
Excellent.
Big, big time. They'll have copies of my book called Prep School. Don't forget that. And there you go. Come out on November 18th.